Good afternoon, I am Sara Jaramillo, not partner is Juan Diego Montoya, and today we are going to present our project, which is the importance of literacy in the... Good afternoon, I am Sara Jaramillo, my partner is Juan Diego Montoya, and today we are going to present our project, which is the importance of literacy in the students when learning a second language, a bibliometric analysis, with the assessor, Angela Patricia Velázquez. In order to carry out our study, we set off two of the main constructs from the theoretical framework, which are deafness and literacy. Deafness, according to Peluso 2005, can be defined from a classical clinical medical perspective and from a sociolinguistic perspective. The classical medical clinical perspective sees deafness as a disability, while the sociolinguistic perspective sees deafness as a way to be and to be in the world. Also, the World Health Organization categorizes deafness according to the level of the hearing loss. So it could be mild, moderate, severe, and profound.
Well, the next construct is literacy, and as we know, literacy is simply defined as the ability to read and write in any language, but some authors, such as Hosse in 2015, disagree with this idea, and she said that it involves something beyond that. And another author, Sanchez, 2009, emphasized that the literacy process involves phonemic awareness, spelling, and word recognition. Phonemic awareness constitutes a crucial moment to initial literacy, since children can relate the letters of writing with the sounds element of speech, I mean with the phonemes. And also, Hosse in 2015 mentions that the recognition of words is the relation of the words with other words and the context. Since, as we know, isolated words do not proportionate any information at all. So the literacy process is by what we decipher, analyze, and relate the spoken language with the written language and the graphemes. For our literature review, we have checked some documents. The international document is called Literacy Development in Deaf Students, conducted by Evans 2004, and this study talks about the teaching and learning strategies used by parents and teachers in order to introduce deaf students to a bilingual education. And our national document is a document written by a graduated student of the program, Sanabria, in 2019, and it's called Deaf Students and Spoken Language. And his objective was to deal with the lack of academic literature in Colombia, and he offered us information of the physiology and anatomy of the ear, an analysis of his culture and language, and also teaching methods for his community, with all their particularities. And the relation is that they highlight the importance of literacy and the use of sign language to learn a written language, and also that they promote the incorporation of bilingual education for all individuals, no matter his or her condition.
Our general objective is to review information in Latin America about literacy processes in the learning of a second language for the inclusion of deaf students.
We define three specific objectives. The first one is to explore different documents that explain the relevance of the use of literacy in the learning process of a second language by students with hearing disabilities. The second one is to review the importance of literacy for the inclusion of deaf students in society. And the last one is to study inclusion policies for deaf students in the country and around the world.
Okay, and now that we explore the theoretical basis of the project, the next section is the methodology. First of all, it is important to set up some study features, which are the type of research, which is a qualitative research, since according to Punch 2013, it consists on collects non-numerical data and analyze its meaning to help to understand social life through the study of target populations and places. The type of study is a bibliometric analysis, since according to Polanco 2015, it consists on monitoring, evaluating, and reviewing a research process. And the context is primary, secondary, and higher education in Colombia or in other Latin American countries.
And in order to carry out this monograph, we will follow the premises established by Diodato 2012. The methodology we are going to follow has the next step, and my partner is going to start with the first one.
Okay, the first step is setting up the premises that are the languages used, that are English and Spanish, the documents accepted, that are journal and degree papers, thesis projects, books, governmental documents, and documents from the Ministry of Education, and the topic to research, that is the use of literacy in the learning process of a second language by deaf students.
And here you can see some of the databases and journals that we are going to use during the development of our monograph.
And in order to look for the documents in the databases already mentioned, we set up some key concepts that are literacy in deaf education, inclusive education for deaf people, written language, second language acquisition for deaf, and bilingual education for deaf.
For the criteria, we created this rubric, which contains 5 dimensions in order to filter the documents exposed from the databases and journals above. The first dimension is that the document should be a primary or secondary research, could be a governmental document. It should address at least 2 concepts of the ones reviewed in this monograph, and it will have research with the people as participants. And also, it must have documents that present specific results on literacy for deaf.
And also, once we obtain the results for the research, they are going to be evaluated in terms of their relevance and compatibility with this study.
Here, you can see the number of sources we have analyzed up to this moment. Among them, you can find books, articles, governmental documents, and web pages. Here is the QR code for the reference, and if you have any doubt, do not hesitate to ask it. Thank you so much.
Thank you.